Hey guys and girl, and welcome to another World of Warcraft video by yours truly. I'll be running some old world raids in this video, where I will basically, I was going to do it privately just to see how much time does it take to run them and how much gold will I approximately get out of it. But I thought, well, since I'm going to do that anyway, why not make a video out of it? And so that's what I'm doing here. I will be running the Cataclysm raids, Dragon Soul, Firelands, and Twilight Bastion. I could include the Throne of the, Four Winds? But I'm not going to bother because I don't think you really get all that much. Well, I might. We'll see. But essentially what this is I'm going to put it on a timer. Each raid will be on a timer so that you can get an idea of how long does it approximately take and how much gold can you expect to make out of it. So with that said, let's just get right into it. I'm just going to pop my... I'm going to pop a flask, my last flask of greater draining strength, because, you know, why not? They're so easy to get. So we're going to start off, very first, I'm going to start off by resetting my current earnings, my gold earnings. I have this Titan bar panel here. You can see I've already earned some gold this session from doing quests and running around in the world and whatnot. I'm going to reset this, reset current session, so that now my earned gold this session is set to zero copper. I literally haven't earned anything. I'm also going to bring up a little stopwatch here by right-clicking my clock and clicking this show stopwatch. That brings up a stopwatch up here so that I can time my run. I'm going to start with Dragon Soul. And I'm in New Dalaran. The quickest way that I know of getting to Dragon Soul is I'm going to take the portal to the Vale of Eternal Blossoms in Pandaria. And hopefully not get stuck on loading screens, because that does sometimes happen. Once I'm here, I'm going to fly to the portal area. See if I can do my little... Yes, I did not get dismounted. Nice. Oh, I can almost fly already. I'm going to take the portal to Shattrath. Once again, pray to the Iron Jesus gods that I don't get stuck in a loading screen. Thankfully, I did not. And from here, I'm going to fly outside, get to the tavern in Lower City. I'm going to go talk with Paris Hilton. I'm sorry, I mean Harris Pilton. We don't want to get sued, do we? She is not in there. Over here. I love this city. Shattrath. It's one of the best main cities ever, in my opinion. Here he is. Oh, it's not even Harris Pilton. It's Zephyr. Where is Harris Pilton? She's in here somewhere. Anyway, talk to Zephyr. Take me to the Caverns of Time. Now, you might not be able to do this, because I do believe it depends on having done some old pre-quests in Burning Crusade. So if you haven't done those... you might not be able to get portaled by her. But if you can, then this is by far the fastest way from New Dalaran directly down to the Caverns of Time that I personally know of. If you know of a quicker way, let me know. I'd like to find out. So, we're going to go for Dragon Soul, and while I'm flying there, I'm just going to change my raid difficulty to 25 player heroic. It's already set to it, so that's fine. I don't really need to change anything. I'm just going to go straight there. It's a small flight. It's not very long. It's a nice area. I like this. Look at this. This is beautiful. Wonder what those planets are. One of them isn't... They're definitely not Argus, because we do see that in Gul'dan fight in Nighthold. I just saw that the other night, and I was blown away. It was... Wow, it's such an amazing fight. Okay, Dragon Soul is right here. Once I enter Dragon Soul, I'm going to start the timer, and I'm just going to double check. We've already reset our gold. I should have inventory, enough free inventory space to actually carry the items that I will be getting. I hope so. Let's get started. World of Warcraft Cataclysm, Dragon Soul, the downfall of Deathwing. Now, this dungeon, this raid does take some time to do. I'm going to start the timer. I'm going to mount up. I actually dismount. I'm going to mount up again. And I'm just going to go through it as quickly as I possibly can, because that's the whole idea, isn't it? We are farming these old raids just for the gold, to earn the gold as quickly as possible. We don't really want to spend any more time in here than we have to. So I'm skipping as much trash as I can, because I don't think it's worth doing, at least not in here. Go for the boss really quickly. They're going to die so fast. I mean, at 110, stuff just dies really, really fast. And actually went out of range. And I pulled trash somehow. Anyway, first boss down, on to the next. Nice and easy, very, very quick to kill the first boss. I always like that. But the problem with Dragon Soul is that it's a very slow raid. There's not really a lot of trash in here. Blizzard kind of decided, let's do something different. Let's not have a lot of trash, but instead let's gate everything behind time-consuming roleplay chats between NPCs. So there's a lot of that. It's basically just standing around. Which, in my opinion, I'd rather prefer actually having to run through the dungeon, killing trash, rather than just standing for several minutes listening to NPCs talking to each other. That's not very engaging. I don't think many people like killing trash, but it's still preferable to just standing around doing nothing. I'm gonna go for this guy really quickly. He's gonna pull all those blobs, that's fine. Because they actually drop some stuff. There we go. Make sure I've picked everything up. Yep. Moving onwards. I'm going to sell all of this trash, which of course will be included in the overall earnings. Luckily, I mean, in the past, I remember, we kind of had to hold on to some of these items for transmog. We thankfully don't need to do that anymore. With the wardrobe system, which is such a good addition. I really love it. Next boss, the third boss. I don't remember offhand how many bosses are in here. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, I think. I think there's 8. 8 boss fights, so to speak. Actually, this fight has become slightly less annoying, because in the past, whenever you aggro the boss, you automatically aggro all of the trash in the room as well. So you had to run around killing all this trash. You couldn't just go and kill the boss and then run out. You can do that now, which is really nice. I don't know when they changed it, but it's a good change. It's nice that they go back and change little things like that. Because it was very time-consuming. It seems you truly are the heroes of legend. I'm going to assume that I have enough inventory space that I don't need to sell anything right now. So that's 3 bosses down. We're going to go to the 4th boss now. And this is where the time gating starts. The annoying NPC role-playing begins. Where I'm just going to be spending quite a bit of time actually just standing around picking my nose. The first boss here is hidden behind a lot of chit-chat and talk. Right here. Thrall being very dramatic. We are never lost, Alex Drasa. Caligos has a plan. It just might work. And his plan involves me. May allow us to converge the magical matrix contained within the Dragon Soul. So yeah, this is what I mean by time gated, you know. There's no trash, I don't have to run around, I can just stand here and be really, really bored. Which is, it's not a good design. It's an annoying design. I'd rather be running manually. I'd rather be killing trash than doing this. We have no choice. We must have faith in our allies. I will not fail you, Thrall.
Then I will open the way into the eye of eternity.
Excellent. You must not fail. I will. I just told you I won't. Okay. Chill. As always, as they always do. There we go. This is going to open, and now I can get to the boss. Finally. That only took, what, 1.5 minutes? 2 minutes? Well, not 2 minutes, but it did take some time. It gets worse. Don't worry. It gets much worse. So, boss fight is almost starting. We actually do have a bit of trash, but it's quickly dispatched. Really doesn't take long. Especially not with warrior mobility. Trash dies very quickly, although now I can't get to these guys. Everything is on cooldown. Sadly, I don't have the heroic leap shoulders. Those would be really handy doing these old world raids. You just jump back and forth. Multiple times. That one's down, drops a bit of gold, and now comes the boss. Shh. Be quiet. I'm just I spent all my rage. There we go. Boss down. Next. Next boss is, you guessed it, a lot of roleplay chat again. We were successful, Caligos. What? I'm not a titan, am I? Next fight is Ultraction, which is the fifth. It is the fifth, isn't it? Yes, it's the fifth boss. And this is going to take a long time. There is actually trash on this fight, but it's the trash will come to me. I don't go to the trash. Oh, what a surprise.
You must protect us from Deathwing's forces while we imbue the dragon's soul with the power.
What if I say no? What if I just do this? Sleep. Ah, okay, I gotta speak to him. We gotta do this. Gotta get us started quickly, because there's even more roleplaying, even after we start. Now we have about another minute of roleplay before the actual trash begins, and then we get to the boss. I swear, just give me halls and rooms and catacombs full of trash. It's gonna be quicker than this. I love this guy. I don't know. I do like Deathwing's voice, but he should have been a bit more dramatic. I love his voice in the cinematic, like the expansion cinematic. Oh, it's amazing. Once you hear him in-game, he still sounds cool, but he sounds way more sick in the actual Cataclysm cinematic. I wish he did sound that way in here as well, but sadly no. And Ultraction. I hate Ultraction's voice. Just wait until you hear him. You've probably heard him before. But if you haven't, oh no, his voice is awful. It doesn't fit him at all. So this is the trash. We have to kill a certain number of these blue drakes. I don't know the exact number, but it is definitely a number. It's not time gated as such, it's just kill gated. You have to kill X amount and then the boss comes. And as a melee, you can probably do this faster if you're a range class. I'm pretty sure you can do it faster as a range class. Because my ranged attacks as a warrior is extremely limited. I have one. One. That's all I have. And it's on a 6-second cooldown, so once every 6 seconds, I can do a ranged takedown. The remaining time, when it's on cooldown, I have to taunt them to actually come down to the ground so that I can hit them and smack them in the face. I didn't actually count how many. I should have done that. We're nearly there. Should be. Really can't be that many left. Oh, I didn't even hit him. One more. No, that was it. Okay, good. Here comes the boss. Now, check out his voice. I think it's a big miss on this guy's voice. Ultraction, for such a big, dramatic, badass dragon, he really should have sounded a lot more intimidating than he does. Also his name, Ultraction. It's a badass name. You'd expect him to have a badass voice, but no. It's disappointing.
The hour of twilight is nigh. The sun sets
on your pitiful mortal existence.
I sense a great disturbance in the balance approaching.
Yeah, this is one boss fight. It's taking like 5 minutes. I'm sorry, that's just... his voice just does not work for me. It's so... It's so unfitting. It just, look at him. And then listen to him, like, what the hell? You should have had this really deep, menacing, booming voice. But no, he sounds like some sort of TV reporter. Anyway, boss fight down. That took way too long. Next boss fight coming up. Again, not really any trash. Just more standing around waiting. Sadly. Annoyingly, frustratingly.
I will not fail this world.
Good guy, Thrall. Okay, come on. Let's go.
Welcome aboard.
There we go. Thank you. Our aim. Let's go, boy. We are the Horde. We are ready to face our doom. There we go. Okay. This is the... What is the sixth? Seven, eight, nine? No, it must be the... Wait, I lost track. How many did we kill? We killed the big guy at the start and the old god thingies. We killed the shaman. We killed all traction. What's the number? Yes, this is the sixth, right? It should be. This is the sixth fight. And again, there is trash, but it's part of the boss wave itself. It's like waves of the trash mobs. And when the trash mobs are dead, I'm just once again just standing around doing nothing. Welcome to Dragon Soul. Waiting for my rogue throw. Oh, I didn't even... Oh, okay. He did die. I'm not worried about the ship taking all this much damage, because there's no way this is... You can't fail this unless you literally go AFK. Even though there is technically a fail mechanic, regardless of what level you are, because if the sky, what's it called? The sky what? Skyfire. If it does reach zero hit points, zero health, which is the one you see here, you die and the boss, you fail the boss encounter. That can happen if you literally don't do anything. But as long as you just kill the trash and, stop the little infiltrators from running into the cabin, then you'll be fine. You don't have to stand. Normally you have to soak those purple pools on the ground to avoid the Skyfire taking extra damage. At least that was the original mechanic when this was a relevant raid. The Twilight Sapper onto the deck. We just killed these guys. It's not long now, and he's gonna come down. We can finally kill him and his drake. Or well, it's a drake. No, is it a dragon? I think it's a drake. I don't know. It's too small to be a dragon, isn't it? It's a big drake. That's what I would say it is. Yeah, it's a big drake. It's not a dragon. Come on. There's no point killing those drakes that drop these guys off. I have tried. Their health freezes at 1 HP. They don't actually die. So you cannot stop them from dropping these Vrykul on the deck. No matter how hard you try. There we go. Now he's coming down. So we got to kill this guy and... and then his health is going to freeze at 1 HP. Surprise, surprise. There's very little one-shotting in here, actually. Just because everything is either gated behind these long roleplay sessions, or because, like this, their health just freezes because you have to wait for some other mechanic, which is the drake coming, and then her health freezes, and then he dies, and then... It's very confusing. Everything's very confusing. That was the sixth fight. We've got the seventh fight, which is the spine of Deathwing, which is a pretty amazing fight, but it's kind of annoying, even at this level. At least there's no... Well, again. There's no... I was about to say there's no trash, but I guess technically there is. This is, again, a very time-gated fight. It really does take quite a bit of time, because you have to do this. So I'm just going to kill two of these guys. And you have to constantly run left and right on this spine. Otherwise, oh, I accidentally killed. Actually, my trinket killed him. I don't want that to happen. You have to continuously run left and right. Otherwise, you die. It doesn't matter what level you are. It doesn't matter if you have a billion hit points. You die. If you don't do the mechanics, you die. So this is definitely not an AFK fight by any means. And if you've never done it before, even at level 110, chances are you're going to probably wipe. Because at some point, you're going to forget running left and right. And then Deathwing's going to roll, and you will most likely fall off his back and fall to your death. So, yeah, another very time-consuming fight right here. We have to get these guys to... they need 9 stacks of whatever that explosive thing is, which we create by killing the... Where are they? The Corrupted Blood. We kill the Corrupted Blood. They leave a pool of burning stuff on the ground. We drag this guy over them, and he gains a stack. You see, he has 6 right now, Absorbed Blood. When he has 9, he goes Supernova, Unstable, Explosive, Future High-Tech stuff. And what we need to do then is dragging him up to this armored plate on Deathwing's back. Kill him, and he will then explode, tearing loose this plate, which allows us to get closer to, basically, to Deathwing's head. And all the time, you have to constantly move back and forth, left and right. Never stop. A burning tendril. See? Now we have more space for moving around on, but the mechanics haven't changed. It's exactly the same mechanic throughout the entire fight. You still have to move back and forth. You still have to kill the Corrupted Blood and make sure one of these guys gets 9 stacks, then bring him up to another one of these armored plates and do the same thing over again. You just keep doing that until the encounter ends. Thankfully, the further we get in terms of progress on these armor plates, the more Corrupted Blood we spawn, and the faster our, what's it called, Hideous Amalgamation can get his 9 stacks. So the fight does speed up progressively. My bloody trinket killed them. I need to keep an eye on that. I have the, I should actually have unequipped that, to be honest. You might want to do that. If you have an AoE trinket that randomly procs on this fight, you might want to unequip it. It's procced again, and it killed him again. This is going to add some extra time to my, to my timer. I should probably deduct like a minute, because this is a bad mistake by me. And if you don't have this trinket, you won't have this problem. I can't even unequip it now because I'm in combat. Can I? No, I don't think I can. I gotta get to the other side before Deathwing rolls, or this will be a very horrible run. Come on, absorb these, will you? I didn't actually want to kill that. That was another mistake. Well, it's fine. I'll just kill this guy. Gotta get some more bloods. Where are they? How many stacks does he have now? I'm trying to constantly monitor my... Oh, man. I just killed him by accident. I'm fucking up so badly. I need to monitor my buffs to make sure that I don't get the trinket proc without me noticing. I need to click it off really quickly. Okay, let's... There it is. Get it off, get it off. I didn't... This bloody trinket. How many does he have? He has 8. I need one more. Please don't proc my trinket, because it's going to insta-shot him. Okay, good. 9 stacks. Wow, I'm really... This is screwing up my timing so bad. But here we go. Let's get a good run on the last plate here. Just gonna get one of these guys out really quickly. Kill these off as fast as I can. Gotta get to the right side, back to the left side. We don't want to fall off. Blah. I thought I had. Oh, that was. It was not my trinket, that proc. What was it, actually? It's because I gained a stack of focused rage. Never mind, I'm a bit panicked right now. I don't want to mess this up again. We've wasted way too much time on this fight. This fight should have been over, like, at least... Oh, I just hit him by accident. Oh, man. Should have been over at least a minute ago. Eight. Just one more. Got this one over here. Come on. Come on. There we go. Got to get over here. Kill this guy. Okay. It nearly went wrong again, but we did manage. That's fine. Everything's okay. But yeah, you can probably shave off... When you look at my final time, you can probably... What? Ignore. You can probably shave off like a minute, maybe 2 minutes off of my time just because I wasted so much time on that fight. If you don't make that many mistakes on that fight, it's at least 1, maybe 2 minutes faster than what I just did. Just keep that in mind. So the last fight is coming up and there's more roleplay, there's more waiting around. Not a whole lot, but still some. It wouldn't be Dragon Soul without it. Thank you. I agree. Come on. Come on. Let's go. We are in a hurry. Well, not really. Inconceivable. And this fight is... Well, for a boss fight, at least there's no trash as such, but... You can't just walk over and one-shot him, because you actually do have to jump between platforms, killing his, wings and hands and tendrils and whatnot. His claws. He's got many claws. I suppose two of them are his actual hands and the other two are the little cute mini hands at the end of his wings, aren't they? So we destroy these, get back to the this middle platform and smack him in the face and time. We're done. So, 23 minutes, 1 second. That was my timing. I think you can easily do this in 21, maybe even 20 minutes. Because I really did fuck up on the spine. But that's essentially the time here. Well, I suppose technically the time isn't over until the actual loot cache spawns. Maybe I stopped the timer a little preemptively, but it's over here. I'm on the wrong platform. There we go. Ooh, and I actually did get something that I didn't have. That was an axe, I think. Yeah. Apparently. Right, Dragon Soul. Let's go back to New Dalaran. Sell our loot and check out how much gold did we make in these 23 minutes. If I'm not entirely mistaken, we should be roughly around the 1700 gold or so, approximately. I'm gonna sell this. All of this and this and this. I don't need any of this. And that. And this, and this, and this, and this. I think that's... And that. There we go. Now we are done with Dragon Soul, and the earning is 1,748 gold. That's pretty consistent with what my calculations have been so far. You can easily expect roughly anywhere between 1,700 and 1,800 gold on a Dragon Soul run, and my time was 23 minutes, as I said. That's... Blinktron. Ah, it's Blinktron 5,000. I was hoping for 6,000. Anyway, 21 minutes. I'd say 21 minutes is a realistic time if you don't make that big Dragon Soul spine mistake that I did. For Dragon Souls. Okay, we're going to reset the timer. Going to reset the gold earning. And now I'm going to go to Twilight of Bastion. And from New Dalaran, the quickest way for me is... Portal to Orgrimmar. And from Orgrimmar, We portal to Twilight Highlands and just fly the rest of the way. If you are a lion, it might be actually quicker for you to just portal to Ironforge and fly directly from Ironforge. I think the fly distance is going to be roughly the same for you. I'm not sure though. Well, here we go, Twilight Highlands. Because I'll show you on the map in just a minute. There's a bit longer loading screen here because Twilight Highlands is not normally a place that I go to when I log on to the game, so it has to stream in some stuff. I'm gonna mount up here and fly. The spire is right up there in the distance. So if we look at the map, see, I'm here. This is where I exit the portal. This is where the raid is. If we look at Ironforge is right here. So if you just go out of Ironforge, you have to fly this distance around like this. And it's roughly the same, I'd say. But I don't know. I mean, I haven't played Alliance enough to know which is actually fastest. And either way, I think you are saving maybe 5-10 seconds at the most. So it really doesn't matter. Once we're done with a Twilight Bastion, we're going to go Firelands. And then I suppose I can do Throne of the Four Winds, just because why not? Also, I don't have the mount from Throne of the Four Winds, so that, you know, maybe I'll get lucky and get it on video, even. That'd be pretty cool. Twilight Bastion is a lot faster than Dragon Soul. A lot faster. Simply because there is no time-gated role-playing events. You don't have to stand around listening to NPCs prattling on about you're the greatest hero and Azeroth is in danger. Please save us all. And you don't have to listen to a stupid voice alteration either. You just go in, you run in, charge the monster's faces and kill everything in your sight. It's very, very easy, very fast, very convenient. There's also a lot of trash mobs, which normally when I do this, I kill the trash mobs as well. I've started the timer and let's go. My earnings are reset. Yes, I'm at zero copper. Great. I'm just doing this the way that I normally do this, right? And I do pull all of this trash because, like I said, there's actually quite a lot of trash you can get in here, and it all adds up. There's some nice gold earnings in collecting all this trash. I want to taunt these guys, but I can't. I mean, just charge them. I'm gonna run down to the end here. Get around this pillar and do a bit of spinning. And let these little sheep run right into this death trap. That is me. Let's get all this loot. Nom 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 nom. Yummy yummy loot. Onwards. Boss time. Halfus. Halfus the Wormbreaker. I want some mobility. I want my heroic leap. There it is. Charge, Colossus Smash, Holy Strike, Slam, Execute. Oh, I got stunned. Lovely. And I got a transmog. Malevolence. I'm surprised that I'm still actually getting transmogs. I've done these dungeons many, many times. That's a cool looking staff. Anyway, this part, you do want to kill the trash because this event is triggered by the trash. These trash mobs. If you don't kill them, then the event will not proceed and you won't be able to continue. So you gotta kill these guys. These guys. And the ones at the maybe not these guys, but definitely the ones at the top that I just killed earlier. These guys down here, you don't need to kill at all, but like I said, I like including the trash in these runs because you do actually make quite decent amount of cash from killing all these guys. The problem with this trash is exactly this. This is so annoying. It's very difficult to just pull the entire room because they're gonna do that annoying thing. I don't know what the hell they're doing, but it just completely traps you in a corner. So instead of pulling all the trash, I can usually only pull about, well, I came pretty close to pulling all of it, to be honest. I'm just going to grab these last bits for good measure. And hopefully not get pushed into the corner again. That might happen. I'm not sure if it's these guys. No, I'm fine. Right, boss time. Valiona and Theralion. Yes, yes. Rage, thank you. Mortal Strike, Slam, Execute when I have Rage. And as a warrior, Rage is... Well, as an arms warrior, Rage is a very uncommon thing. I'm not sure what it does because I never have it. Maybe if I had those best-in-slot legendaries, but... Nah. Oh, well. Next boss coming up very... briefly. Thank you. Well, I don't know about that. They reach out to touch the fire. The Elementium block boxes I am actually keeping. I do have a rogue alt. So I'll be sending those to that one to open them. They can contain some nice stuff. Transmogs and whatnot. There's the boss. I'm just gonna hammer him down as quickly as possible. You ideally you want to get both of them as low as possible before you kill one of them. Try and get their health as close. Ah, yeah. See, I messed that one up. Now I get stunned and I have to wait just a couple of seconds, but it's okay. It's nothing as badly as compared to Dragon Soul. And he goes all big and menacing. And I go Mortal Strike his face and then execute. Grab the loot and again, another transmog I did not have. And we are at the final boss. Well, no, we're not. Not on heroic anyway. But we're close. We're nearly done. It's not a long lot of time left. There is a bit of time gating here with a bit of role playing going on. When this guy dies and then when the actual final boss comes. Which is the biggest time-gated boss in here, actually. Again, I just want to kill the trash. It's worth it. It's worth doing. Hey, guys. Oh, okay. Cho'gall. The big two-headed ogre boss of bosses. Let's just, do that. So, he's dead, but there's a bit of role-playing here going on, some event, before we're completely done. It's a cool event, though, I like it. Boom, and then you go, oh, I can't loot him, but I fell down. This is nice. Loot, moving on. And now comes the final boss, Sinestra. In just a few seconds. I swear she's here. She's right here. There she is. Consort of Deathwing. Now, she is the most time-consuming fight in here. Not because she's hard to kill, but simply because... role-playing. Time-gated role-playing again. So it doesn't matter how much I smack her in the breasts and boobs and, well, whatever she has in that general area. She just won't die, no matter what. At least I get rage now. Amazing. Even that one didn't die. Not until it landed. We have to wait for these eggs to become vulnerable. There's two of them. And that's just based on time, basically. You know, you have to do some damage to her, get her mana shield down, but it doesn't matter how far down you get her, she's never gonna die. You just have to wait for this to happen. And these guys keep coming back. You can actually kill them. The barrier protecting the pulsating twilight eggs dissipates. There we go, that's one down. The next one is over here. I'm hoping for the Wimkin that I can charge to, but she's not here, so... I'll have to go the slow way. Can I one-shot it with my axe? No. There she is. That's the one I wanted. Now the eggs are down, I can go back on the boss. And this time she is actually gonna die. There we go.
The fire's dim, champions.
Oh. Or not. Okay. Well, we kill her twice then. Fair enough. I get a lightning strike on my head. A lightning fire strike. And I get to loot the chest. And time. 8 minutes and 6 seconds. That's very, very fast compared to Dragon's Soul, as you can see. See, my Hearthstone isn't even ready. Thankfully, I have two. So we're going to go back to New Dalaran, sell our loot, count up our monies, and then we're going to do Firelands. Firelands is going to take some time, just because it's a very big instance. There is a bit of role-playing in there as well, but not as much as Dragon's Soul, but not as little as Twilight Bastion. Gonna get to a vendor. There's one right here, a cheese and wine vendor. Doesn't really matter. Everybody wants my loot, so I'm fine with that. Gonna sell it. Sell everything. I'm not selling the... there's one thing I'm not gonna sell, though. Because I do need those for an achievement. The cloth. What's it called? I forgot the name of it. This. Ember silk weave. I do have, because I do have the first aid achievement where I have to create 500 dense embassy bandages. I haven't done that achievement yet, so I just want to add a bit to it by doing this, and then I'll sell them. I think I'll keep these two as well. You never know when you can use these. Are crafting reagents. They might be worth something to someone. That's the embassy. I'm gonna sell those. Thank you. Gonna quickly get to a mailbox. Send these to my priest. My good old priest. There we go. Okay. How much money did we earn? 1,019. Not bad for 8 minutes of work, is it? And you can do this on all of your characters. Remember that. So 1,018. So roughly 1,000, right? Plus minus a little bit. In roughly 8 minutes of playtime for Twilight Bastion. Next one is Firelands. Again, the fastest way there that I know of. I'm just going to reset my timer. Going to reset my current gold session. It's now at zero. Yes. Portal to Orgrimmar. And from Orgrimmar, portal to Mount Hyjal. And then we just fly. And I think for Alliance, that's probably the fastest way as well. Obviously not portaling to Orgrimmar. I don't think that's very quick for Alliance, but whatever equivalent you may be using. I'm guessing Stormwind. And the portal to Mount Hyjal is right here. Go, go, go. We're going to finish this video in, I think, less than an hour, which is pretty good. And Sulfuron Spire is right down here. I'm gonna go there on my pink proto drake. There it is, ominous in the distance. The fiery eye of Sulfuron. Its piercing gaze burning the embers of your soul. And not with a stupid voice like Ultraction. This is a nice looking place. The whole World of Warcraft is just one hell of a nice looking place. I've always really loved just the whole visual style of this game. It's wonderful. It's ageless, isn't it? Even 12 years after its initial release, it still looks amazing. Okay, Firelands. There's going to be a lot of loot in here. Usually that means I will actually have to spend time going back to the entrance and selling, just because my bags are going to fill up. Do we wish to reset? Yes, I suppose. So we're going to start the timer and go, 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 go. Off we go. I'm going to pull a lot of trash. I'm not going to pull all of it, but I'm going to pull a lot of it. One problem with trash pulling at 110 is sometimes you have to kind of just trudge around inside of them for a bit because it takes them a while to realize you're there. You're so high level that they basically can't even see you. And these core... Okay, yeah, so that sometimes happens. I get conflagrated and run around like an idiot. And then I get netted and I get stunned, so... Yeah, if you want to skip this, you can skip the trash, but I still prefer doing it just because, like in Twilight Bastion, you actually do get quite a lot of extra gold out of killing the trash. Or most of it, anyway. Right, not going to bother with the rest. And besides, we do need to kill a lot of this trash to actually spawn one of the necessary bosses to continue. So, some of the trash is actually mandatory. And the trash in this part, on our way to Bethtilak, it's not mandatory, you don't have to kill it, but if you aggro any of it, it's gonna make you a... It's gonna give you a very bad day. You don't want to keep aggro on these guys. Because, like, these spiders right here, the one, these guys, right? If you aggro them and then run past them, they're gonna continue aggroing you, and they will never come to you. They will just stand there with those fiery beams and never chase you down. And what that means is that once you've killed Bethtilak, you're going to be in combat and you will not be able to mount for the rest of the dungeon. See, I'm actually... No, I'm not. For a second there, I thought that had just happened. So, don't skip this trash unless you can completely avoid aggroing it. So, like, if you're a rogue or a hunter or a mage, someone who can clear your aggro from mobs, then you can skip it. But if you can't, if you're like a blundering idiot warrior like me, you're going to have to kill it. Because otherwise you're going to have to run the rest of the dungeon, the raid, without being able to mount up on your mount. And that is really going to add a lot of extra time to your run. And also make it very annoying. So, first boss here. We just aggro her and then wait for the small spiders to come down so that we can go up and smack her in the butt. And that's my butt right there. It's not a very high resolution butt, is it? Blizzard really should spend more time on butts. What? What just? Oh, right. No, I'm an idiot. Get these guys down. Jump on the net elevator. Go up. Hit the boss in the face. You do want to bring her down pretty quickly. So, you know, blow your cooldowns or whatever you need to do. Because there is a mechanic down here. You want to make sure that she's dead when she comes down. Otherwise... These guys, you have only a few seconds before these guys start channeling those spider webs onto you. And if that happens, you're going to be stunned for like 30 seconds and there's nothing you can do about it. So make sure that you bring the boss down to, you know, one health as quickly as possible. Otherwise, you're going to have a bad time. Okay, next I'm going to go to the big lava dude. And I'm just going to pull a bunch of trash while making my way there. Now, I'm not sure exactly what type of trash it is you need to kill to spawn the special boss. But I do believe it's these salamander guys, these big packs of salamanders. Those are the ones that you have to kill. I think. I'm pretty sure it is. If I'm wrong, then, well, screw you. Come here, boy. Come here. Okay, I'm gonna get rid of these. And all of this. And these. And these. And these. And this guy. You hear that horn? It sounds more urgent, guys. Something is coming. And it's not Freddy. I'm gonna pull all of these dudes. Because they deserve to be pulled. Flamewalker Overseer. Hellhound. Deadhound. There he is. We've spawned him. He's gonna come walking. I'm not gonna bother with him right now. We'll get him sooner or later. I wanna go up here and get this guy first. This big guy here. Lord Ryolith. I'm probably going to aggro these small guys, which is slightly annoying, but it's not a big deal. They should come to me. Kill him. Get over to this guy. Stack up some of that stupid focus rage. Charge him, hit his legs, make him dead, and just, you know, splat, 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 splat. Kill that guy and loot him and move on. And again, I got something. Volcano spike. That sounds. What is this? Is that a two-hander? No, it's a one-hander. Shame. Is that the volcano? It is. I just aggro these. I'm an idiot. 71 copper, guys. 71 copper. Totally worth it. Next boss is the fiery. I forget her name. But there's also a mount in this raid, so that's exciting. I'm not sure which boss actually drops it, though. The mount is basically Alice Racer, which is this one. Or Alice Racer. Alice Racer? I don't know how to pronounce it. It's the boss itself. The mount is the boss itself. I am actually not sure if you have to kill this trash. I'm pretty sure you don't need to. But if you aggro it, you're going to have to kill it. We're going to go aggro this guy. And then here's the first time-gated boss in here. It's going to lock us in a... I think it's a 30... Oh, 40 seconds. 40 seconds root. Oh, poor Druids. I wish I could watch her reduce your pitiful band to cinders, but I am needed elsewhere. That's why you were just walking aimlessly in circles, right? Before I came? Yeah, makes sense.
I serve a new master now.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna send you to a third master in hell. There we go. Down, dead, no mount. I don't know, I don't think the mount drops from the actual bird, but it might. I mean, maybe it does, I don't know. There's no mount, of course not. Why would there be? Let's see if we can catch this guy. Actually, he's, where is he? He did spawn, didn't he? Shanox, where are you? Yes, he's, oh no. Oh, we've just missed him. Okay, I'm gonna go meet him, because that's gonna be faster. You wanna not aggro these guys up here, there's no point in doing it. You don't have to aggro them, you don't have to kill them. But if you do aggro them, you have to kill them, and they won't run to you. That's so annoying. And they have like 90% damage reduction, which... Even at 110 with artifacts and stuff, it's still going to take a few hits to actually kill them. That's sort of a waste of time. This guy just dies. Move on. What hurts? Fire? No, I guess my sword hurts. I can't blame him. So I'm going to see if I can get... And they actually have a huge aggro range, even at 110, so... Make sure you walk in a big circle around them. I'm gonna go kill this guy, Balrock. Don't have to pull any of this trash, just run past it. It's not worth killing, they don't really drop anything significant, so just skip it, go to this guy, kill him, execute. And another transmog. Helm of Blazing Glory, is that nice looking? Where is it? I don't see it. I don't know. Click the thing. And now there's a small time gate when we wait for the bridge to form here. But it's not, it's like 15 seconds, 10 seconds, 15 seconds, I don't know, 10 seconds. And then another 10 seconds actually crossing it. But yeah, usually what I do now. So I'll just do that because I don't like leaving anything behind. Like, I want to pick up literally everything. There's only two bosses left, but I can already tell I don't have inventory space enough to actually pick up everything from those two bosses. So what I'll do, I'll just use this portal, go back up here, because there's a vendor right up here. This is going to add a couple of minutes to your run, but whatever, who cares? Sell this and get back. Sell. Selling everything. It's a fire sale. Get it? Fire sale? Come on, that's a good one. Living Ember, this stuff. Did I get rid of everything? Yes. Okay, good. Onwards, back to our mission. Infernal Hawk. Back to the portal. Then we're gonna go kill Majordomo Stackhelm, and then Ragnaros, the Fire Lord. Solfrion Keep. I still need to do this achievement, but it's not soloable, so I have to rely on other players. If you want to help me do it, feel free. If you need it yourself or something. Or if you're just a nice kind of guy or that one girl on the internet who actually watches this. Majordomo has a lot of health. Kind of surprising. Because as you can see, there's a lot of items from just this one guy. And I had like, what did I have before? I had 12 inventory spaces left or something. This guy dropped almost 12 items. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. He dropped 10 items. Raki is going to drop at least 10 as well. So I would have run out of inventory space if I hadn't gone back to sell. This guy dies. We're nearly there. Now I'm lacking mobility. Where's my run fast potion? Oh, I don't have one. Where's my double leap legendary shoulders? Oh, I don't have any. Where's my fel... Oh, I don't have any. Where's my... Kill these guys. I usually don't bother looting them. They don't really drop anything. 41 silver. Yay. Worth it. Ragnaros. Oh, look. And mini Ragnaros. Why not? Two supermortals. Yeah. We've heard it all before. Just be quiet. Now, I haven't seen him not do this. I don't know if it's possible to prevent him from doing this. Because this is taking off a few seconds of your run, but... you know, I just have to deal with it. Oh no. The Sons of Flame reached the hammer. What am I going to do? I took zero damage. I'm going to get back in here. Get in the middle. I'm just going to run in the lava because I don't really care. Because his hitbox actually shrinks when he goes into this form. And there we go. Run is done. 13 minutes and 15 seconds for Firelands. He's dead. Chill, dude. Like, what the hell? Fucking Cenarius. Traitor. Scumbag. Back to New Dalaran. Gonna go sell this stuff quickly. Let's see if we can very quickly get to Throne of the Four Winds before our 1 hour is up. I don't think we can, but it's gonna be close. Sell what? He didn't want... Oh my god. Are you kidding me? Well, I'll be an old pirate's head-eating parrot. I got the freaking mount. Are you kidding me? What in the freaking flucking flop? Well, there you go. So apparently making World of Warcraft videos gives you mounts. Where the hell are my mounts? What's it called? Firehawk. Fire. Pure blood Firehawk. Set favorite. Mount. I'll be an uncle's old perverted aunt. There we go. What a beautiful thing. I didn't even bother looking for it in the raid. I just assumed I didn't get it, and there we go. It's right there. That's amazing. Incredible. Anyway, okay, gold. Yes, I got sidetracked a bit. Sorry about that. Where's the gold? So Firelands, 1646 gold. So again, it's roughly the same as Dragon Soul, and just about at half the time. It took about 13 minutes to do violence. Let's just include... what's it called? Oh, I even got a... I even got an achievement for it. Did I? Did I get an achievement for it? I didn't even see. No? How did he know? I don't know. Tanks. Okay, reset the timer. Reset our goal counter. Reset current session. It's at zero. Yes. Good. Throne of the Four Winds. Fastest way that I know of. It's back to Orgrimmar. Take portal from Orgrimmar to Uldum. And fly. That's essentially the fastest way. I'm pretty sure. Look at this nice burning... bird. It's my burning pirate. Parrot. Of doom. And death and destruction. Here we are. Portal to Uldum. Well, maybe if I didn't waste 2 minutes just getting completely flabbergasted at getting that mount, we might have been able to do this within an hour, but... no, I don't think so, because it's like a 5-minute flight just from Uldum to the actual, too soon. Raggy is not pleased. To the actual raid instance, which is up here. Throne of the Four Winds. What's our time? I've got 5 minutes left on my strength flask, which was like an hour. Yeah. So we're going to be able to do this in just over an hour. Which is not bad. And so far we've earned, what was it, 1700 from Dragon Soul, 16.5 from Firelands, that's 33.5, and then 1000, that's 4300 roughly, maybe a bit more. And we're going to get in here, we're going to get about Throne of the Four Winds is 200-300 gold, something like that. It's not much. It's about, I think it's about 300, maybe 400 gold. So all in all, you can probably expect, if you do these four instances and not fuck up too much, you can do it in roughly in an hour and you're going to get roughly about 4,500 gold out of it. And possibly mounts, as you can see. It can actually happen if you haven't got them already. Many of you probably have, because you're not plebs like me. But Throne of the Four Winds is going to go really fast. There's no trash, there's two bosses, it's quick. And I really like the mount from in here, it looks amazing. I'm going to start the timer and off we go. On my pink love drake. Well, we're very straightforward. Go kill these guys. Dead. D-E-D. Go kill the next guy. This should take like 3 minutes. Four, maybe. Kill him. On to the next. If I don't get knocked off the platform, that might happen, because like I said, I'm a pleb. I'm bad. I'm sorry. Come on. Come on. There we go. Dead. Oh, okay. I didn't mean to do that, but... it's fine. I'll loot them afterwards. I'll just go for the boss immediately. Stack up my Focus Rage. Get a Colossus Smash. Boom. Dead. There we go. 1 minute. 1 minute. This took 1 minute. And that was it. Oh, then that happened. But whatever. The bosses are dead. I can just go loot them. How amazing would it be if the mount just dropped here again. That would be so, so sick. Hint, hint, Blizzard. I did get some greaves. Right. Those ones. Gonna go back, sell, and that's the end of the run. Actually, we stayed within an hour, I think. This was still within 1 hour, even despite wasting a handful of minutes on stupid things. So that's pretty excellent. Let's just see how much money we get. I'm estimating about 300. I don't think there's a lot more than that. How are you? Done. There we go. 254. Yeah, that's pretty close. So yeah, roughly 4,500 gold for under 1 hour of work doing the Cataclysm raids. And there you have it. It's pretty consistent. I've done this a few times, and it works pretty well every time in terms of the amount of gold you get and the time it takes. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it was helpful to you. I certainly enjoyed the... I enjoyed the run. I enjoyed it. And I enjoyed the mount as well. So that was cool. That was good. Everybody's happy. I'm happy. Are you happy? I don't know. Anyway, thanks for watching. Comment, like, and subscribe. And if you know a faster way, if you have any tips or tricks on how to do this even better, please feel free to share. I would love to hear it. I don't know what else to say. I'm just going to say goodbye. See ya. Take care. Bye.